today's show.
A tip from Coach Pete.
Let's talk with Mr. Rosenberg about the Orphanians' latest concert.
Another announcement from Tag.
Another inspirational quote of the week.
All this and so much more. Good morning, Staples.
Good morning, Staples. It is Thursday, October 23rd. I am Matthew Pryor.
And I'm Miley Fitzpatrick. We have a great show for you today. Before we can begin, will you please all rise for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
On Wednesday of last week, the music department had its first concert of the year. This concert was the idea of our new choral teacher, Mr. Luke Rosenberg.
Traditionally, the first Staples concert each year was the December Candlelight Concert, but Mr. Rosenberg had an idea for an earlier October concert. We heard it was a great concert, and so we asked Mr. Rosenberg about it.
I'm Colin Hoy, here with Mr. Rosenberg, to tell you a little about the Parlor Concert that just went on here at Staples.
So, Mr. Rosenberg, could you tell us a little about the Parlor Concert and why you do it every year?
So, my idea for this concert was to have an intimate setting with just friends and family, and students here at school performing some music that we've been working on at the beginning of the year.
What are some of your favorite songs and performances from the Parlor Concert?
So, first of all, the theme of the concert was new and old, music composed before 1600 and after the year 2000. The old stuff, before 1600, started with chorus and chorale. They sang a piece, for example, one of the pieces was called La 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 Je ne l'ose dire. And it's a beautiful piece, it's funny. It's about a bunch of women gossiping about another woman who's not exactly faithful to her husband. But it's all meant in fun, and it's hilarious. Going on from that, we got into some of the new stuff. A cappella choir sang a piece by Stephen Paulus called The Road Home. It had meaning to me because I actually sung that piece. It came out the year I graduated from high school and I sang it in college. What brought extra meaning to it is actually Stephen Paulus suffered a major stroke in July 2013 and actually just passed away this past Sunday, 4 days after our concert. So. Of complications from that stroke over a year ago. So that was kind of a wonderful piece, and you know, we did a great job. Caitlin Bowers was the soloist. She was gorgeous. And then we ended with the Orphanians doing an arrangement of a piece called Ubi Caritas. Ubi Caritas is a chant that we know was written somewhere between the 4th and 10th century. It was a Gregorian chant piece.
Thank you.
contemporary composers have gone through since and reworked the piece, composed it with contemporary harmonies, and just put a contemporary spin on it. And that piece was the one that we did, was written by Renee Clausen, and just really difficult, lush, thick, eight-part harmonies, and a really tough piece, and I think we did a really good job for only having four rehearsals with it.
Thank you, Mr. Rosenberg, for your time, and now we're going to throw it back to the host.
Looks and sound like a great concert. Congratulations goes out to the students of the music department and to Mr. Rosenberg.
Last show, we had an announcement from TAG, and today we have a follow-up announcement from the group. Here it is.
I got in an accident while texting and driving.
Thanks. Go out to the members of TAG for that update.
Some of you might have noticed that there are tables and chairs popping up all around the school. We heard that Mr. Dodig had a hand in this, and so we thought that we might ask him about it.
Hi, I'm Ben Gasparis, and I'm here sitting at one of the new tables implemented by Mr. Dodig. It's awesome how much these tables really have changed the environment in the school, and we went to talk to Mr. Dodig to find out more about that.
One of the things that came out of the school climate committee that I was part of last year was that we learned from students that they really would like a place where they could just sit and hang out, talk to each other, do homework, use their laptops, in places other than the cafeteria or the library media center. So I bought 12 round tables. I'm sure you've seen some of them at the ends of the corridors in the first floor, second floor, and third floor of the new building, and three chairs, I think, at each of the tables. And they're being used. So because I saw them being used, I bought another 25 of them, and they're about to come in. And we're going to put some in front of the auditorium on that upper level, some outside of the Library Media Center, and another six or seven or eight on the bridge, which is the area between, on the second floor, between one end of the building and the other end of the building. And if I see them used, we can see what else we can do.
Yeah, hi guys, I'm Pete Caligari. I'm the maintainer here in Staples High School. I was asked by the kids about the tables and the chairs that I've been putting together, and as far as I know, they're going at the ends of the hallways for so you guys could have some quiet time and study time.
Thank you, Mr. Caligari, Mr. Dodig. Now let's throw it back to the host.
We think the tables and chairs are a welcome addition to the school, and they certainly have become very popular very quickly.
Mimi and her group is back with another inspirational quote of the week. Here it is.
Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts.
Mimi, we are sure somewhere Kelsey is smiling. Thanks for your inspirational quote.
Ms. Capozzi from the Guidance Department has an announcement for you.
Hey kids, Ms. Capozzi here with your first message from your friendly guidance department. Couple things. Seniors, listen carefully. This one's for you. Many of you have already seen Ms. Ketley for transcript releases for college applications, and if you have not, make sure your counselor's aware of what your plans are for after high school. One. Two, freshmen, this one's for you. Thanks for coming down to see us. We truly appreciate it. Your job right now as freshmen is to do your best in school, have some fun, make social connections, and get involved. That's it. Don't worry about anything else right now. Sophomores, juniors, don't think we forgot about you, because you're next. Keep your eyes and ears open for messages from the Caped Counselor. She's on her way.
Thanks, Ms. Capozzi, for the update.
And now it is time for some sports.
Welcome to the sports section of the show.
Ms. Capozzi is not the only one with a tip for you this week. Here's this week's coach's tip.
Welcome back for another edition of Coach's Tip. This week we're with head football coach, Coach P, and I'll throw it back to him and see what he has to say.
Okay, I'm Coach P, and this is your tip for the week. And I discuss this with my football team all the time. My tip for you is this. Enjoy where you are and stop worrying about where you're going. Okay, because apparently that's what happens a lot, not only here, but all across the country. Don't be so concerned about things that are in the future. Enjoy where you are now. Thank you.
Thanks, Coach, for that great tip. Now let's hand it off back to the host.
Thanks, Coach, for your useful and wise tip.
The boys are back with this week's edition of Just Outside the Locker Room. This week, they are speaking to you about the girls' swim and dive team.
Welcome to this week's edition of Just Outside the Locker Room. This week we are with the girls' swimming team. This is Manahil Salam, junior swimmer. So Manahil, how's the team been doing so far this year?
This year we've actually been doing a lot better than last year. Our lineup is a lot harder. We're swimming teams like Greenwich and New Canaan, and our record is 5-4-1. We had a tie this year, but overall our swimmers have improved a lot.
How do you deal with the pressure of competing in meets?
Well, there's definitely some strong rivalries with other teams in the SCX. That's hard pressure-wise, especially because a lot of our swimmers are on club teams with some of the other girls. But swimming against our friends actually helps a lot because it like motivates you to go faster and your team's always there to cheer you on.
So do you prefer a cold pool to compete in or a warm pool?
Actually, the Norwalk pool yesterday was really warm, and I think that's one of their tactics because they're like used to the warm pool and they have little tricks like that, like flat walls and stuff like that, so cold pool's better.
And how do you deal with the distraction of the water polo team, always practicing after you, you know, always around the pool? I mean, it must be hard to deal with that.
Well, actually, they've been a lot better this year. They don't jump in all over us when we're trying to get out of practice, so that's a good thing, but, I mean, the car wash, we work together, so that's good.
Yeah. All right, you heard it here first, Staples. Thanks for joining us on another episode of Just Outside the Locker Room, and now back to the hosts.
Great job, guys, and great footage. We want to be sure to thank Mrs. Lauren Bullock for it. If any of you are on teams which we have not covered and have access to the footage of the team play, please contact us or Mr. Honeycutt.
Well, it is time for Mr. Klein and his Klein Challenge. He has lost the last 3 weeks, and we are now all anxious to know if Noah Lomnitz can keep the student streak alive. Let's see.
We are back. Klein and Zito here once again for week 6 of the Klein Challenge and week 8 of the NFL season. Zito, sorry we missed you last week. I'm not sure what happened to you, but I was waiting for you.
I was here.
Okay,
you're
here this week. That's what counts. Quick little happy recap of last week, although not so happy for Mr. Klein.
Happy okay?
I went 2-1 last week. Not bad, but not good enough. Noah Lomnitz went 3-0, another losing week for Klein. That makes 4 in a row. Three perfect weeks in a row by the students.
This is like that, taking candy from Klein.
I won't say that, okay? And actually, Zeitz, I don't find this that funny, okay?
It's pretty funny.
Students are now 12-3 on the year. Klein is now 9-6, okay? I am not, 3-game lead. I will not take this lying down, okay? The students have awoken a sleeping giant. They have stirred up the hornet's nest a little bit. I'm actually pissed off. I'm gonna do whatever it takes. I'm gonna work as hard as I have to turn this thing around, and it starts right now. Let's go, Zeitz. Enough of this.
What is he talking about? We'll be right back.
I am here with Tripp Backus, who is the next contestant on the Klein Challenge. Tripp, thanks for being on the show, buddy.
Thank you for having me.
Tripp is a sophomore, okay? And Tripp, what kind of football fan are you?
I'm a Dallas Cowboys fan.
Another Dallas Cowboys fan. Either they're all coming out of the woodworks, okay, or we got some lifers. Woodworks, Fairweather fan, or a lifer, Tripp?
My whole life been a fan.
You're a lifer. I love it. Okay, Tripp, give me your three picks for week six of the Klein Challenge.
For week six, I'm going to have to go with the Patriots over the Bears, the Bills over the Jets,
okay,
and the Saints over the Packers.
Saints over the Packers. Okay. I got to be honest with you. I think there's a lot of pressure on Tripp here with three perfect weeks in a row from the students. I think he's letting me back in it with some of those picks. Watch out for the Jets with Percy Harvin. Okay, and you know what? The Bears looked bad last week, but you know what? I have a feeling about the Bears this week. Here's the direction I'm going in. I am going to go with the Denver Broncos and Peyton Manning over the San Diego Chargers. I am going to go with the Cleveland Browns over the Oakland Raiders. And my lock of the week.
Ooh, that's a big lock, all right.
I'm going with the Kansas City Chiefs over the St. Louis Rams. That's it for week six of the Klein Challenge. Enjoy the games. See ya.
This is the first time that the students have taken the lead and have held it against Mr. Klein. Well, we will have to see if all his training has helped his selection of next week's winners.
Well, that's our show for today, Staples. The Period 8 class will be back next Wednesday with our Halloween-themed show. And we hope to be back in a week with our show. Goodbye. Goodbye. Thank you.